Yeah, hello everyone. Welcome back to another edition of our Training Under the Go Digital online course. In this episode, I'm going to explain to you how to write, publish, and market an ebook. I want to assume that you have decided, excuse me, if this is applicable to you, that you want to start offering your digital products with an ebook. This may not be 100% of the cases with everyone. What I mean is, it is not all of you that want to start offering your digital product with an ebook. But for those of you who have decided to start with an ebook, based on your idea, based on who you are, based on your knowledge, based on the resources available, and every other thing that I've mentioned in the previous videos, so you want to start with an ebook, this course, this episode is for you. And the way I will do with this episode is that I'm going to first of all take you on this slide presentation, then a PowerPoint presentation. Then again, we'll now go live on how to publish and we'll write an ebook, we'll publish it, and I will show you different ways to market it under social media marketing and email marketing. So let's go. The first question you want to ask yourself before you start writing your ebook is the question of why should I write an ebook? What are the benefits? Why should I care about writing an ebook? And I think the first one is the first benefit for you as an author of an ebook is that it establishes you as an expert in your field. For example, if I write an ebook about entrepreneurship and people get values or they gain values from the ebook, without me telling them I'm an expert, they start seeing me as one. Then I start to naturally and automatically establish myself as an authority in the field of entrepreneurship. The first reason why I think everyone should write an ebook is the way it establishes you as an expert. People tend to when people read your ebook and they learn so much from it, without you having to tell them that you're an expert, people start to see you as an expert naturally. And when they start seeing you as an expert naturally, they start respecting you, and that is a good one for you in your career as an entrepreneur. Another reason why you should consider writing an ebook is when you write it once, you earn forever. In December 2014, this is a case, a particular case study from me directly. In my health and wellness business, in December 2014, during the Christmas holiday, I was at home. And I felt like, okay, let me just look for a project to do. So I decided to write an ebook, and in 2 days, I finished it. Then I launched it on through my mailing list on my wellness business, natural health and wellness business. Then I was offering the ebook for 8,500. That was December 2014. This is 20 March 2019. It means from 2015, 16, 17, 18, and this is the 50th year run in 2019. I am still selling the ebook. Actually, I'm not selling it for 8,500 naira again. I'm selling it for 5,000 naira. But imagine an effort of 2 days in 2014 still fetching me money every month regularly since then up till now. And it's not going to stop even in the nearest future, or even it's not going to stop unless I bring it down and I start giving it for free. So ebook gives you an opportunity to start making passive income with little effort today. So you want to consider writing one. Another reason why you should consider writing an ebook is you are able to reach many people quickly with a single, instead of, this is one thing that I like an ebook for, as against publishing a physical, an hardcover book. I encourage people to publish an hardcover book, but when you are starting out and you want to reach people so fast, it is better that you start with an ebook, because people can download it and share it with other people. People easily, especially when, even if you are selling, if it is not for free, people find it that, okay, instead of ordering for an hardcover book and wait for days before it is delivered to me, as people are reading your advert about the ebook, they want to buy it now and consume it or read it right now. That is the essence of an ebook. So because of the speed of the delivery, you are able to reach as many people as possible. Ebook, when you give it for free to build your mailing list, is also an opportunity to grow your own tribe. You can use it to build a tribe on WhatsApp on Facebook, on email list, anywhere. You can use to build a tribe on Instagram or any social media platform or messaging platform today. So what matters is if you're a farmer and you want to grow followership in farming, write an ebook that helps people to solve a particular problem or that teaches them about something. Look for people that need it and offer it to them. Then these people will become your followers. You can also use an ebook to build an email list. My own strategy with strictlybusiness.ng when I started last year was I wrote two ebooks. I wrote one from earning 6,000 naira monthly to owning a group of companies. And I wrote another one, the top five online businesses to make money in Nigeria. When I wrote the first one before the second one, but I realized that I shouldn't be pushing the first one. Then I started pushing the second one. That second one, between December and now, I'm having close to 4,000 people now on my email list because I try to get like maybe 50 to 100 people per day at times. So at times I get more than that. At times I don't get up to that. But I get average of about 100 people to the mailing list on a daily basis. And if you calculate that, that's about 4 months because I started towards the end of last, I think November or December last year when I launched the mailing list actively. So what I'm trying to say is that I have an ebook that I give for free. The only thing I use to attract people to that email list is the ebook. Come and download this ebook to learn. And from there, I'm building my own tribe. From there, I have people I sell stuff to. From there, I have people that I even help free of charge by answering questions. So I have built an email list. All these are the reasons why you want to consider writing an ebook. Then I have also met people that will tell me that a plan B, I would love to write an ebook, but the idea I have, it cannot fly as an ebook. It will fly as a video course. It will fly as this. It will fly as that. But I am going to tell you today that you can write ebook as in you can write ebook about anything possible. If you can think of it, you can write an ebook about it. You can write an ebook about media. You can write an ebook about farming. You can write an ebook about the economy. You can write an ebook about cooking. Young ladies, I do not know what our young ladies these days do with their brains. I still keep making the exam. I have not really, maybe because I'm not a woman, nobody is targeting me for that, but I've not come across, or my wife has not told me, coming across somebody offering a free ebook on a variety of Yoruba soups you can cook to keep your Yoruba husband at home. 20 variety of Igbo soups to keep your Igbo husband at home. The same thing for Hausa. Do the same thing for Ibera. Do the same thing for Tiv. Do the same thing for Ijebu people. Do the same thing for just be smart people. Think. Write an ebook and you will see a lot of women will be downloading the ebook. From there, start selling something. Start selling spices. Start selling herbs. Start selling this. Start selling that. Start offering seminars. Start calling yourself a coach or anything for women empowerment. Because start offering marriage counseling. Because what you are doing by offering soups, knowledge about soups, is you're helping a lot of people to fix their broken homes, or even breaking homes. Some houses are breaking now. They have not broken totally. They are breaking because the husband does not come to eat at home again because he's complaining about the wife cooking a particular type of food every day. And the lady does not know how to cook another one. So, and you people, you can cook. When I visit some people and they cook food, I'll be like, this is sweet. So what are you making any more from this? My job will not allow me. Who says you should go and open a restaurant? You don't need to open a restaurant. All you need to do is to sit down, write an ebook, and say how to cook jollof rice. The best way to cook 10 things that should be in your jollof rice. Ha, God. People know how to cook jollof rice, but they will want to see what is inside your ebook. Design the cover page. Give it out. 10 ways to become a successful young farmer in Nigeria. Put it out. 10 ways to survive as a single lady in Nigeria. Give it out. Work-life balance for women. Put it out. Tell me what you cannot write an ebook about. There is nothing you cannot write an ebook. If you are a successful career woman, you have a beautiful family, good children, God-fearing husband or anything, everything is working fine for you and your career is going fine too. Write an ebook about how you have been able to to be a successful career woman and a successful housewife to your husband and a successful mother to your children. Put it together, call it work-life balance. How I've been a successful career woman for 20 years, still keeping my husband and home intact. Or give it any beautiful or catchy title and people will grab it. From there, you can start your own tribe, people. Eh? All these people you are seeing on Instagram offering all sorts of things, the white people, even some black people, they do not have two heads. So the only problem you have is thinking that your mindset is limited, thinking that I cannot do it. What? Why can't you do it? You can do it, man, and you got to do it, please. Then moving on, I'll now show you eight easy steps to follow if you have decided to write an ebook or to publish an ebook. Number one, you need to understand your main goal and objective of writing the ebook. So this is where people get it wrong. I read a lot of ebooks. I also see a lot of online entrepreneurs offering an ebook. You need to set the goal and objective of the ebook. When I was writing my own ebook, the top five online businesses, my objective was I wanted to use this ebook to attract people to myself. How do I mean? When they read it, they should subscribe. They should want, when they, if they say they want to read it, they should first of all subscribe to my mailing list. When they read it, I should not disappoint them in such a way that when they eventually have my ebook, they will not vex and then unsubscribe from my email list. So they should read the ebook and fall in love with me and what I do. And I achieved that. So that was my objective. I want to use this ebook to build my own tribe, to build people that will believe in me, to build people that can learn from me, to build people that we can become business partners, to build people that in the next 1 or 2 years, they look back and say, thank God I met that guy. Thank God that God bless the day I downloaded that ebook. God bless the day I was browsing and I saw that advert. God bless the day I came across that blog. God bless the day I saw the guy on Instagram, and so on and so forth. That was my goal and objective. I was going to sell something to people I was at any point, but the first objective and goal was, let me build followership. Let me build my own tribe. Number two, choose a topic that interests your audience. See, writing an ebook is not about you. Nobody gives, nobody cares about, I don't want to use the F word now. Nobody cares about who you are, the problems you have gone through, or the success you have achieved. Nobody is interested in that. People are only interested about how the knowledge you have is going to help them. Simple. So you are writing not for yourself. You are writing for your audience. So write what your audience want to hear, and keep quiet about your own life or whatever it is that you think you can use to impress people, or you can use to cajole people or anything. Just focus on your audience and make sure that you are hitting them at the sweet point. The next one is, you have to make the title catchy and specific. Don't make it too negative. Don't make it too positive. Don't make it sound so too sweet, but make it catchy. Make it something that once they see it, they will want to go. It will ginger curiosity in them. It will spike up curiosity, like, I need to see what is inside this ebook. And do not lie. Do not write a title whose content is different from that. The content is different from what you used to catch them. People will vex and they will never trust you again. They will see your advert, they will not trust it. They will see your Facebook fan page, they will even unfollow you. They will see your Instagram, they will not even take it seriously. And they will not do it alone. They will tell other people that guy in a lie. Now, one thing you go put for the title, now nonsense you're going to see inside the ebook. So make it catchy, but do not lie. Another one is, you create your writing outline, topics, and parts, meaning that you don't just start writing. You create an outline. Which one do I want to write first? Come up with your course content or the ebook content. Then you can compartment. You can make your writing in sections or in parts. Part one, part two. Part one, two topics. Part two, one topic. And or you can just make them in topics, but make sure that where you are supposed to be talking about finance, you are not talking about marketing. Where you are supposed to be talking about marketing, you are not talking about customer satisfaction or customer service. So you put the content in different parts where they should be. When you write and it flows accordingly, people will follow. They will not want to stop reading the ebook. They will fall in love with you. I am telling you what I have seen, what I have experienced. People will tell me that I started reading your ebook yesterday night and I could not sleep. I made sure I finished it and I downloaded the second one immediately. I finished it too. I have not done that in the past so yet. Well, I've never done that in my life that I will read an ebook and I will not be able to stop reading it. So that is how good. It's not, I'm not saying I am the best, but I tried my best to make sure that the flow was in a con it was appropriate enough, one step after the other. Don't go and bring the most advanced first. Start from the basic to the intermediate one, then to the advanced, and so on and so forth. There are some people that told me that they wanted to do my Go Digital course. I told them, go and do the 3-in-1 master class first. And there are some people that they wanted to buy the Go Digital, and I said, yes, go ahead. It all depends on your level, because if you start from where you're not supposed to start from, you're going to confuse your audience, no matter how good you are. If you want an ebook to entertain people, to grab people's attention, you need to add images, infographics, and other visuals. You know what images are? Infographics are things that you will see some images, some creative that contain maybe statistics with pictures and stuff like that. Those are infographics. They will say, oh, 5 ways to stop smoking. They will now put the 5 ways, everything in a particular creative. That is an infographics. You will see analysis of data and everything, like where you see people analyzing the election with data and areas and everything. They will put the analysis there. That is infographics. Then other visuals are other things that you can use to drive home your points in a visual way that people can see physically. And so this is what this guy is talking about. Try your best. Don't be lazy. You see, a lot of people are lazy and they want to compare the result they have, or the result they get with the result other people get. You cannot, and because the thing is, you cannot, you have not put enough efforts in your work, so you want to compare results. You don't compare results at the surface. You compare results, you put everything side by side. So and some people will come to me and say, hey, my advert is not delivering, my this is not. So when you now go to analyze, you see that they have jumped a lot of steps. See guys, there is no shortcut to success. So you either do the work or you get out of the way to go and do something else. So add images. Everything you need in form of an image is in Google. There is nothing you want that is not in Google. And if it is not in Google, go and use Canva. Some of you know already, I've seen my trainings on how to use Canva to develop beautiful creatives. So do that and add it to you. When people see that, they will see that, oh, this guy is giving a lot of value in his ebook, and this ebook is free. Oh, and this ebook is just 2,000, and this ebook is just 3,000. This is massive. This is interesting. So in Nigeria, people will send me an email and say, oh, so I can't believe this is happening in Nigeria. I'll be like, what? Like, what have I done? Because an average Nigerian is lazy. They just want to put something of low quality together and think that people will just rush it and then it will become rich overnight. I'm sorry, you got to be kidding yourself and not me. Then you proofread before you publish. Read, 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 and read. Get people to read it for you before you publish it. My number one pest, the first person that proofreads my work is my wife. She's a very careful person as a medical practitioner. So she reads, and her grammar is good. I'm not saying she's perfect, but at least when she tells me that it is fine, then I get another person to vet it for me. When they say it is fine, then fine. What I want to do is, I'm not trying to say there won't be any error in my work, but at least let it be to the barest minimum. So that when people read your work and there are a lot of errors, when they read 2, 3 lines and they see errors, like 10 errors in on one page, they get discouraged, they get uninterested in your work, they get tired, they get confused, like they can't even put everything together to make sense to them. Because when people read what is wrong, they want to correct it in their own head. You are giving them too much psychological headache. So people want to read and be entertained and smile in their head subconsciously. in their spirit and soul and smile and say, wow, this guy is making my day. Not when you blow grammar. I'm not saying when you don't understand English, you cannot write an ebook, but write it the way you want it, then get somebody to help you to correct the errors. Then, before I move on about the proofreading, make sure your grammar is correct. Then punctuation, put comma where you need to put it, put hyphen where it should be, put full stop where it should be, put paragraph when you need to use paragraph. Just make sure that everything is, when people are reading, they are reading and they are enjoying it. Then use the right color combination. Go on Google and put color combination for ebook. You will see, maybe blue and white will go together, maybe red and yellow will go together, whatever color wants to go together. Go and Google. Don't chat me up or send me an email and ask for color combination. I'm not an artist. I'm just telling you. Well, anytime I want to do an ebook too, I ask people, do these colors go together? I like I have always said in all my trainings, I am not an artist. I'm not a professional artist. So I also seek for people's opinion. So don't think that I have answers to all your questions about some things. I am a bloody businessman. I only know how to make money. I don't want to be a professional graphic designer. I don't want to be a professional color combinator or whatever, if that English is correct. But what I'm trying to say is that you to be smart, go to Google. What, before you ask me any question, ask Google first and get clarity first. If you are confused, then ask me. I think the last question you want to ask me is, what color can I use for my ebook? I will not answer you. So go to Google, ask for color combination. A lot of free information is there for you to use. Then lastly, publish and promote your ebook. I have a lot of people again that have sent me emails. And so I know some people will still send me tomorrow and next tomorrow to tell me that there is an ebook they have written since 2 years ago, 5 years ago, 8 years ago. Even before me, I started doing internet business. They have written an ebook, but the ebook is on their laptop, is on their phone, is inside their email where they kept it. They have not published it, not even to talk of promoting it. Some have published it, they do not know how to promote it. There is no essence when you have an ebook that you have not published. Then publishing is not enough. You got to promote it. Do Facebook adverts. Tell people, give people for free. Send it to people to market for you, and so on and so forth. So we'll break all this down more. So moving on, what are the common mistakes you need to avoid before you write your ebook? Guys, see, I'm not making it it's not as if I'm overemphasizing, but I'm only trying to not produce half-baked entrepreneurs, online entrepreneurs. Get all these facts correct. These are things that other people avoid in their trainings. That is why eventually you cannot put the pieces together to make something good out of it. So, and I will try my best not to leave any stone unturned. So common mistakes to avoid when you want to be an ebook publisher or an ebook author is, number one, don't choose a topic you know little about. If you choose a topic you know little about, you are going to goof, you are going to fumble, you are going to make a lot of mistakes and errors, because people that will download your ebook, some of them are knowledgeable than you. I've had senior internet marketers downloaded my ebook that will call me, they will chat me up, or they will send me an email and say, oh, fantastic, I already know, I've been doing this thing for so years, but reading your ebook cleared some doubts I have. Reading your ebook actually taught me some new things. And they are not even ashamed to mail me, because I am writing on something that I am, this one, we go die there, I know I'm, and I know I'm front and back, middle, up, down, sides, everything, to the best of my ability, and I can stand in front of anybody to talk about it. That is what I want to write an ebook about. I stopped writing ebook about health because I realized that when I am writing, the flow is not, so I have to go and Google, search a lot of things, I have to ask people, so that is not flowing so naturally for me. Sure, I have experiences to share, I have cases of clients I have attended to, my company has attended to, but notwithstanding, that is not my core. My core is here, teaching people about business, because I've been doing businesses for over 10 years. Even when I was young, I was helping my parents to do different businesses, and they know me among other children that this one is money matter. Anything that has to do with money and book, now there you go, Sam. So choose a topic you know about so much to avoid making mistake. If you choose a topic you know little about, Not don't do and choose a topic you know little about and offer ebook because they say it is selling. You will fumble. If everybody is selling, you may not sell. If people mistakenly buy from you, they will curse you and say that stupid, that bastard, that 419 sold this crap ebook for me. They will and you will not last. You can make that money and say, multi-jello, but eventually you are actually not going to last it. I have seen it. I have seen several people. So choose a topic that you really know about. Then thinking for your audience. Don't think, like I said earlier in the previous slide, don't think for your audience. Don't think you know your audience. Don't think you know what they want. You cannot know what they want until you ask them. Like I've mentioned again in this course that I didn't plan to do any course called Go Digital. I had other plans in my strictly business.ng business plan. But later, when my students from the 3-in-1 masterclass and people on my mailing list started asking me several questions about several, I said, this is a good business idea. Let me just package something. So I asked them, if I package it, will you buy? I said, Oga, we'll buy now. This one that we bought from you is even making sense. So if you do another one, we'll buy. Some people sent me testimonies that I recommend Plan B. If he does something again, I will buy and patronize him. And yes, they are doing so. So don't think for your audience. Don't think you know what they want. Ask them what they want and offer it. And when you're asking them what they want, make sure that you ask them if they will be able to buy it. If they say yes, then go ahead and do it. Then writing without a plan. Don't just start writing. If you do that, you will start in January and you will not finish in the January of another year. So you need to have your plan. Give yourself a time frame. I want to start today and finish it next week. I want to start today and finish today. I want to start this morning and finish this night. It means you want to dedicate your time. So, and plan your book. I'm writing five chapters. This first chapter will be about this, second one will be about this, third one will be about this. I'm writing just one chapter and it will flow like a story. Whatever it is that you want to write, just have it planned. Then the fear of not making sense. So you are trying to make your ebook too valuable. At times, even me, I find myself in this situation because I'm an advocate of over-delivering. I like to over-deliver in anything I do. So there are times I'll be like, have I given enough? Would this person be able to put these things together to make sense to him? Would this person? So, and I realize that it's like I'm mistakenly becoming a perfectionist too, and that is not too good. You can't be perfect, but at least just make sure that at least if me to somebody sells this, if somebody is trying to sell this to me or somebody sold this to me, I'll be happy with the content. Then I move on. Then I ask people, if you see this, look at it. Is this something you think you can buy? They say, you're fantastic. You really did well. Are you just hailing me or you are saying the truth? So, really? It is the truth. So then I take it as the truth and then I start offering it. I don't waste too much time thinking that I have to give it everything in one course or one ebook. So don't fall victim to that. Then if you write only when you feel like writing, you will not succeed with ebook. You just realize that every other person has started, they have launched, and they are making money while you are still in chapter one of your ebook. Don't write only when you feel like writing. You have to write even when you don't feel like writing. So, guys, what I'm trying to say is that don't be lazy. Then, quitting too soon. When you put the ebook together, and you feel like, this is too much work. Plan B did not tell us. Or when I saw his advert online, he told us I will make millions. He told us, so he didn't tell us it's going to be tough like this. Some of you quit just exactly when you are supposed to be reaping the fruit of your labor. Just like in Facebook advert, I used to tell people, when you do an advert, you are expecting magic the same day because the advert you did last week or last year converted exactly almost immediately. Facebook adverts changes every time. The policies change every time. The dynamics changes every time. So if the one you are doing today, you are expecting the same result. So you are changing your advert every 2 hours. You are just wasting your money. So you are quitting too soon. The same thing with your ebook. You face a lot of challenges. You internet issue, light issue, and so on and so forth. A lot of things will discourage you. Or people are not buying. People are not responding at the beginning. Instead of you quitting, seek for help from people that have done it successfully before. So let me quickly tell you about the tools you need to publish an ebook. The tools I use, there are a lot of tools. In fact, there are some apps, there are some plugins that people use to churn out ebook, but the one I use and I'm satisfied with, some of them are long process, but I like it that way because I like to have control over what I do, and I like to go through what I do because at times when all these apps and plugins, when they do my ebook for me, the grammar they use, I'm writing for Nigerians, so I want to write it by myself. I want to write in the language they understand. Most of these softwares you are buying to write your ebook are made by ebook people. They have been programmed to write like ebook people. So when you deliver your job to Nigerians like an ebook man, they will read it and they will not get anything. But when I write and I put jokes personally, when I write and I put maybe something that is happening, maybe PDP and APC, your software does not know PDP and APC now. So, and I put infographics, I put a lot of, although some softwares actually do like human, but I'm just telling you that the tools I want to show you here, they are not the absolute tools. You also can use other tools. You can go online and buy softwares, use other, but this is the one, these are the ones that I use. Number one, I use Microsoft Word for writing. I use a MacBook, but I have Microsoft Word on my MacBook. I type my ebook word by word, word by word, word by word by myself. I don't give it out to anybody on Fiverr. I have time. When it comes to delivering courses, ebook and everything, I have time. I want to make sure that I want to go through the ebook myself. As I'm typing it, I'm reading it in my head like, okay, am I making sense? That is what I want to enjoy the experience. Then I use Canva to design my ebook cover. In fact, that is the first thing you want to do. And I encourage you to do it. Design your first ebook, the ebook cover, and keep it somewhere where you always see it, so that the ebook cover has a way of making you to think like that you already have an ebook or you already have a book, and it is a good one. It's a good motivation. So every day, every morning you wake up, you look at that, okay, I need to get this ebook out there. So design your ebook cover with Canva, which I'm going to give you videos that explain to you how to do that. Then ebook design and publishing. It is the same Canva.com that I use to design my ebook and publishing. You, I will also do a video for you guys, or I already have a video for you guys that you will watch to learn how to design and publish your ebook. Canva for ebook cover, the same Canva for ebook design and publishing. Then I use small PDF to merge my documents if they are more than 30 pages. So on canva.com, you cannot publish an ebook that's more than 30 pages. So let us assume that your ebook is 45 pages. So I will do the first one 30 pages. I will do another one 15 pages. Then I will merge the two together on smallpdf.com. If my ebook is 120 pages, it means I will do 30, 30, 30, 30. Then I will go and merge everything. And Canva is free, although they have a paid version, but the free version is also unlimited, as you will see in the videos that I will show you when we get to the practical session. Then the next one is I use adhesin.com to do the 3D ebook cover creator and converter. What this means is that there are some ebook cover. When the ebook cover you are going to create on Canva is not 3D. So when you finish creating it on Canva, you now export it to adhesin.com, where you will now convert it to 3D. Those are the ones you see with different shapes and sizes, facing something, somebody carrying it on their hand, and so on and so forth. We do all those on adhesin.com. Or you see your ebook inside somebody's phone, like somebody's tablet or inside a tablet. And it is free. Adhesin also have the paid version, but I have never paid for anything in publishing my ebook. Everything is free. All my images from Google. The one I don't get from Google, I design them by myself. I write it on Canva. I design it on Canva. I publish it on Canva. And that is it. So let's talk about how to market your ebook. Number one, you can give your ebook away free of charge. At least you can give some copies away. And don't forget, ebook, once you publish it once, that is all. The others are just to be sending to people. It's not like the physical hardcover ebook where you have to publish and print, 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 print. Your investment is once with ebook. The others are just to be sending it to people. So give some copies away and let people give you feedback about it. The feedback is what you now use as testimonies to market the paid version of the ebook. Or even if the ebook is paid, give it free of charge for some people. Just say, oh, follow my this thing on Instagram. I have this ebook for you. Get five friends of yours to follow me on Instagram and Facebook. Just get something to be done and give it for free to people. And then part of the condition is that they will give their feedback. When they read it and give their feedback, collate it and use it as testimonies, then start selling the ebook and put their testimonies. Take permission from those people if you have a relationship with them, that you are using their messages or their feedback as adverts, and you are free. The next one is you get sincere testimonies. I think I've mentioned this, because when you give free copies, you get testimonies from people. Then you can also create a blog or Facebook fan pages. All these are what we will do in this course as we move forward. For the purpose of selling your ebook, you can create a blog, you can create a Facebook fan page. You can also do the two together. You can make your email list. You can market your ebook to your email list. If you have an email list of 1,000, 10,000, 100,000, 500,000 people, market your ebook to them and make some good money. You can also record a video about the book and upload it on YouTube. So the lessons in your ebook, you can turn it into a video, talk to people about the video, and then use that message to market your ebook. Then another thing you can do is that you can get a sales page for the ebook. When you create a blog, you can dedicate a whole page to the ebook to sell the ebook, and then people pay you for it. Then you can also run adverts on Facebook, on Instagram, on anywhere online, in your email, on Google. You can run adverts and people will actually patronize you if your ebook is actually available. So all these are different ways to market your ebook, and this is where we are going to stop on this in this session. And as we move on to the practical session, where you're actually going to see in the next video, actually, where you're going to see how to write an ebook, how to publish an ebook, how to market an ebook, and so on and so forth. The totality of how to get an ebook done is the next video you're going to see or you're going to watch. Thank you so much for staying with me.